Howdy folks, this is Shane. I'm here to show you the best way that I found recently to string up my Gibson style electric guitars. My friend Rick sent me a video of Joe Bonamassa's guitar tech showing how he does this. I used this method on two guitars recently for two separate gigs and it worked like a charm. This is one already done. So this is what it looks like close up. This is really easy to do. This will of course work for both left and right-handed guitars as the process is identical. This video is aimed at tuners that have holes through them like Gibson guitars, Toco guitars and so forth. The first step is to put the string through the bridge and then pull the string tight, so there's next to no slack. Now, what you want to do is take the length from here to here and drop it back. You're only dropping it the distance between one tuner, so that's it. The first step is to wind the first turn over the top of the string you've just threaded through. Now, as you begin to wind, you want to make sure that the following winds that you do go underneath everything that you've done so far. So you'll have the initial wind that goes on top. You can also kink the wire up like that. And then you got to follow it through with the winds going underneath. So what you essentially will do is the string will clamp and lock it in place. Here's what it looks like in close up. As you can see, the final wind is the one that's under the string. So you've got the pull through in the middle, the first wind around the top, and then the second one goes around the bottom, locks it nice and tight. Some of you might be asking, how do you do the D or G because there's no reference? I just use the top of the headstock as reference and I do exactly the same thing. Pull the string nice and tight. I use pretty much here as the reference point. I drop it back. First wind goes over the top. I kink it up 90 degrees. Makes it a bit easier to see as well. And then I start winding. As I start winding, the following wind will go under everything else, so it locks it up nice and tight. Hopefully this view's a little bit easier to see as well, and it makes sense. If you are a right-hander, it's exactly the opposite. So if I'm working from the opposite side of the guitar, I'm always winding the strings into the center of the guitar. This method works a charm, and I can't believe it's taken me this long into playing guitar to work this one out. So huge thanks to Rick for showing me this. I guarantee this will work exceptionally well on any Gibson style guitar. Thanks for watching, my name's Shane. If you have any comments, questions or suggestions about the video or the way that I've strung up this guitar, please let me know and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Don't forget, like and share this video if it was helpful. Thanks.